Sometimes the very best place to find a wild plant is in a hedge, a very long hedge. And we need to know that because we...
Well, hello there, I'm Green Dean and welcome to my 133rd video here at eattheweeds.com. This time about a tropical, subtropical tree with an identity crisis. This one right here. You know, it's had about 24 botanical names because it's in a family that botanists really can't agree on. Now, that's something new, isn't it? Why would botanists keep changing the name? Well, let's just say that the differences are small, but the egos are huge. Right now it's called Mercianthes fragrans, but for a long time it was called Eugenia Simpsoni, and a lot of people know it that way still. You know, and while botanists argue, most folks just call it the Simpson Stopper. It's close related to the guavas, the Suriname cherry, a genus called Caesiums, and the eucalyptus. Now, why call it the Simpson Stopper? It honors Charles Torrey Simpson, who was a naturalist and author in Miami about a century ago, where this tree happens to be native. Or, of course, it's a hedge shrub right here, but it's a tree, actually. Simpson was a mollusk expert. He knew about 10,000 shells on site and all their Latin names, and he retired to Florida and thought his career was over. Then he became interested in botany and started an entirely new career and became more famous as a botanist than as a muscologist or a conchologist. He was called the Sage of Biscayne Bay. He was essentially the John Muir of Florida. He knew Marjorie Stoneham Douglas, and Simpson Park in Miami is named after him. Quite a well-known man in the area. Now, there are several stoppers. They're called that because of the persistent rumor that the trees were used to make a decoction to stop diarrhea and things like that, but there doesn't seem to be any modern substantiation of that. They could also be called stoppers because they're pretty when they're in fruit, and you go, wow, look at that. You stop and look at it. Sometimes I have to appeal to my base, and this plant is definitely subtropical and tropical, although it has edible relatives that can tolerate, once established, even down towards zero. So if you live in a colder climate, you can find an edible relative of this plant and put it in your landscape. You know, a lot of people think of Florida, particularly the peninsula of Florida, as flat, but it actually has a little central ridge. Central ridge, okay. And it's about 5 degrees cooler average in the wintertime on that central ridge. And so this little tree won't grow there because it's just a little too cold. It only likes to go down into the upper 20s. So it grows up the coasts and it grows from Lake Okeechobee south. It definitely does not like cool weather. And in other parts of the warm areas of the world, such as Australia, where the related species, Caesiums are, they too are just as cold sensitive as this one is. So they're pretty picky where they grow. Here, the Simpson Stopper is a very rare plant. So it's been promoted as a native plant to be used in landscaping, hence the big hedge and also the reason why it's behind me. As I alluded to earlier, the Simpson Stopper is actually in the eucalyptus family. If you crush a leaf, I happen to have a few right here, they smell kind of citrusy. Some would say citrus pine and some would even say nutmeg. But they don't smell like eucalyptus, just the eucalyptus does. The blossoms are very showy and very fragrant, pleasantly so, which helps you separate it from a very close relative that has bad-smelling blossoms. That's convenient. The fruit is quite colorful and grows in pairs, hence the other common name for this, the twin berry. You know, they're orange to red, they're very edible, but the quality berries, they can be kind of mealy and soft, sweet. They're usually made into jellies and jams and things of that nature. Now, here, the stopper is being used as a hedge, but it can grow into a tree around 55 feet high. It has reddish flaking bark, which is another source of another common name. It's called the naked wood. As you might guess, no matter what you call it, the tree is an eye-catcher. Here in Eat the Weeds, we itemize. Let's itemize the Simpson Stopper, and we're going to spend a lot of time on identification because it's a toughie. The Simpson Stopper flowers profusely, and they have many stamens. Look very much like the Suriname cherry blossoms. The fruit, as you can see here, is orange to red, and often in pairs. You can see right here, in pairs. And on the bottom side, there's actually a little four-sided, each one has a little four-sided, little round pucker, kind of like a little folded blueberry crown made out of four little triangles. They're closely related to the
caesiums, which look very similar, but they have actually a folded cross on the bottom. Now the leaves, oh by the way, these will have 1 to 2 seeds in there, often together at the same time. These have usually two seeds. We'll pick out another one, see if we can find one with just one. But, still one seed there. The leaves vary greatly. Here we have one with a round tip, here we have one with a pointed tip, and here we have one with a notch at the end. And you're actually looking for all three when you're looking for this particular tree. You're looking for a leaf with a notch, a leaf with a round tip, and a leaf with a point. A little breeze here. The breeze is not helping me do this demonstration at all. So there we go. Notched, round, pointed. Mostly pointed, a lot of rounds, but occasionally a notched. Also, if you had a number 10 loop, like a number 10 magnifying glass, this one here I get this is the one I get from stamp stores, coin shops. If you look at the leaf top, you'll see little spots on here, sometimes clear, sometimes dark, and on the bottom you'll see little spots as well. Often they appear green or black. Also, if you hold this leaf up the sun and look at it through a number 10 loop, you'll see little gold spots shining through. Pretty nice. Also, the veins in the leaf do not come out at right angles as they do with some of them. They go off on more like a 160 or a 20 degree angle. And of course, they're also very, very aromatic. I'm sorry you can't smell those here, but there they are. So here we have the Simpson Stopper identification. Let me see if I can just pull a few of these up, give you some idea of their general size. See, there they are. There we go, Simpson Stoppers. One more little thing about it's not a little thing, it's a big thing. You know, like the Suriname cherry, don't eat the Simpson Stopper fruit until they're totally, totally ripe. If you eat them when they're not ripe, they will insult your mouth. You've been warned. Also, do not eat the seeds. Do not eat the seeds. They don't taste good at all. As a matter of fact, they taste pretty bad.
Time of year. It can fruit and flower almost any time, but it favors fruiting in August and September. Environment. Full sun to partial shade, likes to be irrigated, it's hardy down to about 25 degrees Fahrenheit, often found growing over limestone, shell, or marl. This is a warm climate tree only. Its close relatives, such as the Eugenia myrtifolia, once established can get down to zero, but this one can't. Method of preparation. Pulp of the ripe fruit is edible out of hand. The texture is soft and mealy, sweetish, and it can also be used to make jellies and jams. By the way, while you're out there, you might come across other stoppers. There is the red berry stopper, the red stopper, the Spanish stopper, and the white stopper. Thanks for joining me on this Labor Day for my 133rd video, this one about the Simpson stopper. For details on the stopper and hundreds of other edible species, go to my website, eattheweeds.com. You know, I've got some 19 gigabytes of data there that I'm transferring from one site to another, and it's just taking me a while to get my website up, but we're going to get there. So until next time, this is Green Dean. Oh, by the way, look what I found while sitting here. Amaranth. Amaranthus. Gonna have that for lunch. So, until next time, this is Green Dean. I want you to think green, I want you to eat green, I want you to live green too. Toodles.